So what I'd like to do today is start by discussing some of the basic features that are provided by Java Completable Futures. As you'll see, these are very similar to what is already there with the Future interface. And that's not an accident, because Completable Future implements Future. So of course, it gets all the methods that are defined in Future. So just a quick recap, this should be no surprise. You can block waiting to get a result. You can time block waiting to get a result. You can pull using the get method, variants of get method, the overloaded methods. You can also check to see if something is canceled. You can test to see if something's been canceled. You can cancel something. Oddly enough, for completable futures, cancel doesn't actually interrupt the computation. So it marks that the future is being no longer of interest, the result of being no longer of interest, but the computation still continues to run, which is rather bizarre, and you can read more about kind of why it's like that and what you can do about it at the link at the bottom of the page. There's also a couple of other methods that are very simple. One of them is called join, and join behaves like get, except it doesn't use checked exceptions. And so therefore, you can use it as a method reference in a Java stream. So you could have a stream of futures. You could join all the results and collect the results into a list. You can do that nice and cleanly. Conversely, if you try to use get in its most intuitive way, you have to throw try-catch clauses around the call to get, which, as you can see, is very ugly. And that's because checked exceptions and streams don't play together without some additional wrapping of exceptions and exception laundering and so on, which we're not going to talk about right now. Bottom line is, you're typically better off using join than you are using get if you're using a stream. You can also explicitly complete a future. We've talked about that before briefly. Let's take a little bit closer look at it now. So what you can do by completing a future is you can explicitly set the result that will be returned via get or join. So you can do that by creating an incomplete future. You notice there's no computation associated with this. We could then go ahead and create a new thread. And then in parallel to that thread running, we could do some other stuff at the same time. And then once this thread completes the future with whatever result is being passed back, then anybody who's waiting to join on the future will be able to unblock. So marginally useful. We'll see a couple examples of how to do this. This is not really the preferred way of doing things, but it's something you can do if you want to. Some other interesting variant of this is you can actually create a completed future with a result. So you can come up here and you can create a completable future that has a result already. So it's a future that's already been given a result. Now, why the heck would you ever want to do that? Well, one reason you might want to do that is to initialize a variable or a constant. For example, here we're going to define a constant called zero, which is given a completed future to zero. And then whenever we need to use zero, we can say zero.join, and that will give back the result zero right away without having to block. And you'll see that there actually are some situations where that turns out to be a rather useful feature. So that's the end of the basic completable future features. Again, nothing really outlandish here. It's all the future stuff plus join and complete, essentially.